Excited others, yes. Ready to learn. Okay. Another 10 seconds for people who haven't yet given their expressions for the day. Okay, so students, now I'm going to be telling you a dialogue from one of the movies that we have watched. I'm hoping that most of us has watched this movie, okay? So just let me know which movie this particular dialogue was, okay? So how's the Josh? Hi, sir. Which movie was this particular dialogue from? You all can type in the chat box. If you want to answer off mute, please raise your hand. I hope I was audible enough. Palak ma'am, can you please just confirm if I'm audible?
Yes, you are.
Okay, okay. Okay, so students, again, I'll repeat the question, okay? I'm going to be saying one dialogue from a movie. Please let me know if you can relate to the dialogue. If no, even let me know that as well, okay? So the dialogue is, how's the Josh? Hi, sir. Yeah, so which movie is it from? Yes. Yes, correct, Prachi, Satyam, right. So, yes, yes. So, perfect. The answer is coming up as Uri. Okay, now can you tell me which particular field did the movie represent? What was the movie about?
For class. Let's get.
Yeah, perfect. Army. Perfect, Satyam. Indian Army. 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 Excellent. Yes. So, we got to learn about the Bollywood movies have given us amazing stories when it comes to armies. Okay. What we're going to be doing next today is simple. Yes. Uri, and it represented the army. For today, we'll be following the following norms. It's important that you all participate as you all are doing now. You all are going great. Just keep up the same enthusiasm. Keep putting in your answers with chat. If you all are confident, please come off mute and share. We'll be thinking and sharing our opinions. Make sure if you wish to come off mute, raise your hands, okay? And please keep your textbooks ready. Very important so that you can do the necessary markings and it's easier for you to relate to what will be reading today, okay? Give me the thumbs up if the norms are clear to you. Yeah. Perfect. So, let's just answer another two couple of questions before we start with the lesson. How many different kind of armed forces does India have? Can you name them? Like, one is already given in the chat. It's Indian Army. Which are the other names for the armed forces in India? Yes, Rahul, you can go ahead.
Air Force and Navy.
Air Force and Navy, excellent. Ankit, which is the fourth one? Yes, sir.
And Commander and Para Commando.
Okay, those are special forces. I'm talking about general forces. The one that you said, Ankit, are like special forces, okay? Okay. So there are three major forces in India, which is Indian Army, Navy, and Air Force. Now, in quickly in the next 5 seconds, can you all tell me which force are you most interested in? Which one do you find most interesting? Air Force.
Navy.
Navy, correct. Right. Navy. So you need to give in when you all are answering the force that interests you the most. Please do share the reason as well as to why do you really like it? What is something that you really find interesting about the force? Navy, Army. Yes, Rahul again. Go ahead. Indian Army.
I like Navy because when we will go for fight in water, so we can observe new fish and we can see all the nature in under it.
Okay, Rahul. So you're connecting your duty with your nature as well. That's an interesting perspective. Ankit says, because we support the country. He likes Indian Army because they support the country. Satyam, it would be amazing if you could give us the reason why do you really like the Air Force. Others? Okay, Satyam says that he's never been on a plane. That's why I want to be in the Air Force so that I can sit in the plane once. If you're sitting in the plane, if you're being in the Air Force and sitting in the plane, you will be the one driving the plane, mostly. But yeah, that's also a good prospect. Okay, students. So today, as we already have gauged a little bit of the atmosphere, today we'll be learning something about the armed forces, okay? And we have already had a pre-work of reading the chapter. And I hope you have gone through the chapter. So can any one of you volunteer to let us know what are we going to be studying today? Which chapter are we doing today?
1.3.
Okay, Ankit, 1.3. There was a pre-work for y'all to read and go through the chapter. How many of y'all have done it? Please raise hands. How many of y'all have done it? That's an one. Yes, Karthik, it's Wings of Courage. Correct. Two. So either Chand or Karthik, would you like to just, you know, summarize as to what did you understand while you were reading the chapter before you entered the classroom today? Just in like one or two sentences. Would you like to share it with the classroom? Okay. So before we, so let's go get in the chapter together. Okay. So today we'll be learning about Wings of Courage. Oh, Kritika has given an answer. That is, her favorite is the Indian Army. And because the Indian Army controls the highest battlefields in the world. Perfect. Nice. So what are we going to be doing today in the classroom? It's simple. Today we'll be learning about an Air Force Marshal named as Mr. Arjun Singh. And our major criteria for today's reading is going to be to highlight the words which specify his character. Okay, so like what were his quality as a person of the armed force, how brave he was, and how were the event described in the textbooks? How is the event described? Whether it was very dangerous, whether it was amazing. So these are the words that we're going to be finding today only about the character, nothing else. Okay, so while we'll be reading today, there are certain norms that we'll be following while we read. Okay, so what we'll be reading, can one of you volunteer for the read? So, okay, let me just go for it. First one, we'll repeat it again, okay? First, we'll underline the words which describe the character of Arjun Singh. So, there are a lot of words which are giving you an highlight or an insight about what kind of personality did Mr. Arjun Singh carry with himself when he was in the armed forces or in the Indian Air Force? And how did he work as a soldier or as a person of the armed forces? Okay, so we'll highlight only those words which describe his character, which describe his personality, okay, and the events. While you are reading, you need to keep certain points in the mind. One, what was easy for you to understand? How did you understand it? What connections could you make? And what was difficult for you to understand? Was there something that you really felt was new to you while you were reading? And was so what was difficult includes even the words and the meaning. If there is a character or there is a personality trail which is given in the textbook and you can't understand the meaning, you're supposed to underline that too because it is difficult for you to understand at that moment. Okay. Can I have somebody repeat the instructions, what we'll be doing while we're reading today? Please raise your hand. Anyone? Yes, Ankit, please go ahead.
We will be underlining the words which describe about Arjun Singh.
Yes. And while you're underlining those, what else, what other points will you keep in mind while you're reading the text other than the characteristics of Arjun Singh?
Because it will be easy to understand.
Okay, Satyam, even you raised your hand. Would you like to share?
We will underline the words which describe the character of Arjun Singh and the words that we don't understand that are difficult for us to understand.
Perfect, Satyam. Okay, so let's move forward. Okay, so we'll be doing it first. Let me just, you know, like, this is like a practice that we'll be doing. Okay, so please open page number 15 in your textbooks. I hope we all have the textbooks. So please open page number 15 in your textbook. This is a practice as in how we'll be doing. Keep your pencils ready. Please do not mark with pen in your textbooks. Please use a pencil. Please give me a thumbs up once you're ready with your textbook and the pencil. Open at page number 15. See, thumbs up. Others? Okay. I'm hoping that most of us are ready with the textbooks and the pencil in our hand. So the first one, I will be reading it out and marking certain things. For the next two parts, we'll have a practice amongst ourselves and then we'll continue from the text. Okay. Give me a thumbs up if you understood what we'll be doing right now. I'll be reading first, then the next paragraphs. Okay. Yeah, perfect. So, let me just put in my pointer. Okay, so here we go. Chapter number 1.3, page number 15, On the Wings of Courage. Air Force Marshal Arjun Singh, an icon of Indian military history, will always be remembered as a war hero who had successfully led a young IAF during the 1965 Indo-Pak War. The only officer to attend the highest post of Marshal, the Air Force equivalent to the Army's five-star field major. Singh was a fearless and exceptional pilot who had flown more than 60 different types of aircrafts. He played the major role in transforming the IAF into one of the most potent air forces globally and the fourth biggest in the world. His contribution to the Indian Air Force is monumental to the least. The IAF grew with him. He was the epitome of military leadership in classical sense, and it is therefore not surprising that he was honored with the rank of the Air Force Marshal. Former Vice Chief of IAF, Kapil Kes said. While reading this particular passage, there were certain words which I found were little new to me. So what I'm going to be doing is I'll be taking my pencil, I'll be marking them. So what did I find different was, one, I was supposed to find out the characteristic trail of what Arjun Singh was representing as his personality. So the first thing I got to know that he was a fearless pilot. So that is his personal trait. Okay, that is his character. It's explaining me his character, that he was fearless. He did not have any hesitation when he was doing his work. Then he played a major role in transforming the IAF and to the most potent. Potent is a new word for me, which means powerful or effective. Okay, if you all have your textbooks, you have the meaning right at the right hand side corner. Potent means powerful and efficient. Air Force globally, the fourth biggest in the world. His contribution to the Indian forces is monumental. Now, this particular word monumental is giving me the gauge of the event as to how big the event was. Monumental means a really great or important, very big, enormous, something that was an exceptional, that was a surprise to a lot of people. So monumental is a perfect event explanation. So it is also a new word for me, something that I'm learning while I'm reading this particular given passage. So I'll underline that too. He was the epitome. The next word that is new for me is epitome. Epitome is also, yes, a perfect example. Correct, Tusha. So epitome is somewhere down the line giving a title describing Arjun Singh's personality. This way, I'm saying that Tushar is an example for the class. So I'm giving, I'm somewhere down the line giving one type of title to his personality. So epitome is a title given to Arjun Singh's personality, that he was a perfect example to the military leadership as to how can you carry yourself when you are defending your country. Okay. I hope you have understood these many things that we were underlining. I hope you understood how we are finding, which characteristics are we supposed to, what are we supposed to find in the passage while we are reading it. One thumbs up. Yes, Siddhartha.
Lekha madam, is epitome a title or is epitome the best example in the field, in the specific field?
Epitome is also given to express a particular situation. So if I want to express like best example in that particular field, I can use the word epitome as well. But if it can also be when you want to say that this particular person is the epitome. So it's practically you're representing that particular person to be the best in the field. I hope that was clear enough, sir. Yes. Anybody else that has any questions regarding this particular passage? If no, please give me a thumbs up. We can move ahead. Okay. Let's move ahead. Let us do it together now. Okay. So we'll be continuing for people. If there is somebody who don't have the textbook. Yeah, yes, yes. Now we'll be reading. So now you will be volunteering to read. Okay. So if somebody doesn't have the textbook, I'll be sharing a little bit of the passage over here. But it would be really amazing if you can open up your textbook to page number 50. And we'll start reading from paragraph number 3. So would anybody like to volunteer for the read? Ankit, go ahead for the first one. First, go ahead with page number 15.
Singh was honored with the rank of Marshal of the Republic Day in 2002. Some Horace Musa, Farmaji, Jadeshek, Mashakar, and K.M. Karapia were the only two army generals honored with the rank of Field Marshal.
Marshal. Field Marshal.
Marshal.
Yeah. Next. Continue reading, Ankit.
Known as a man of few words, Singh was not only a fearless pilot, but also had
profound
knowledge about air power and applied it in a wide spectrum of area. Singh had astrology.
Audaciously
lead of IAF during the 1965 war and denied success to Pakistan Air Force through it was better equipped with America support. is
though,
more
this, though it was better equipped with American support.
His most outstanding contribution was during the war, said
Cake. Okay. So within the two paragraphs that Ankit read, did anyone of you find out the any word that describes the character or a new word in the paragraph? Because there is a new word.
Audaciously.
Okay, Ankit. Audaciously, yes, Rahul. Anything else, or is it? Are you raising your hand for the read?
My word also was audaciously.
Okay. Next, there is a character trail that we had done in the last passage as well. There is something that is representing, profound knowledge. Yes, Anushka Sharma, profound knowledge is a new word for you. No problem. There is also one word which is giving a characteristic trail, which we have already done in the previous passage that I was reading. In the same line, where profound knowledge is.
Fearless.
Excellent, Akhilesh. Fearless. So fearless is the characteristic or the personality of the pilot. Profound knowledge means deep knowledge. They know everything. They know the particular topic, or they know about the field in detail. Profound means detail or excellency in that particular field. Audaciously, simple. Audaciously meaning is given in the sight. Also, in audaciously means working hard and showing careful attention to details. Audaciously means someone who is really hardworking, who knows the field really well, but is also aware about what types of steps are needed to achieve that particular success. Audaciously. I hope the meanings are clear for all the three. Others? Yes, Ankit.
Can I read ahead?
No, wait. We'll try and give chance to other classmates. Okay. Then we'll see if we can have another go. Okay. Anybody else would like to have? Yes, Chan. You can start reading from in 1994. Go ahead, Chan, please. Tushar will take
it. Commending.
Yes, from commending. Sorry.
Commending his role in the war, Y.B. Chavan, the then defense minister, had written, Air Marshal Arjun Singh is a jewel of a person, quite efficient and firm, but a very able leader.
Continue, please.
In 1944, the marshal had led a squadron against the Japanese during the Arakan campaign, flying close air support mission during the crucial Imphal later assisted the advance of the Allied forces to Yangon,
formerly known as Rangoon. Okay, so just a moment. Now, let's find out the words, giving another 5 seconds. If you already have the words, let me know. Okay. Rahul, are you raising your hand for the read or for letting me know the word? Same goes for Tushar.
Rangoon.
Okay. Rangoon is a place's name. Rangoon is a place's name. What was another word that which you found was different? Tushar, do you have?
Miss, what is meaning of formally?
Yangon.
Formally, okay, just a moment. Let me help. Commending his role. Commending means praising. Commending means praising. Officially praising. Shabashi dena. Kisi ko shabashi dena. Kisi ke baare mein tarif karna. Commending means. Formally. Yeah, others who have raised that. Chand, Tushar.
Miss Squadron.
Squadron, yeah. Squadron is a team. In Air Force, in all the armed forces, when you're leading your team, they're all given different kinds of different names or the titles. So squadron means a team that was working under him.
Miss, what is the meaning of campaigning?
Campaign, yeah, Impala campaign is the mission. Campaign means it's a workstation or the work that they would do. Like during COVID, we had a lot of giveaway campaigns. Like if there is somebody who needs to, people are going out and they were helping people who could not have proper food or proper clothing. So they were like campaigns run by NGOs. So these are like events wherein you somebody train.
Surviving.
Is it a word or you're giving me the meaning?
I give you the meaning.
Surviving means to किसी चीज से बाहर निकलना होता है. Surviving is different than camping. नहीं, it's different अंकित. Surviving means किसी चीज से हम fight out करके उससे बाहर निकल रहे. Surviving का meaning वो होता है. Campaign is a event that you organize. Or campaign is a training or a particular kind of practice that you do. Yes, Tushar. There was another word which came into. I'm not getting it. Which you had asked. Which one of you had asked? Any other word?
Unacceptable.
Firm and unacceptable. Unacceptable means they did not give any kind of excuses or any kind of bahane. He was really well disciplined in his work. Yes, Rahul.
Yangon, miss.
Yangon is a place name. Now it is known as Rangoon. I'm so sorry. I don't know the exact. State where Rangoon falls, but Rangoon is a place's name. And somebody asked me the meaning of formally. Formally means the previous captain or the previous head. Now they might be retired or now they might be, no more in the world. But formally. Formally means previously.
Miss, what is the meaning of allied?
Allied forces means somebody who is with us in joint force. Our friend, allied forces. Tushar, I'm hoping you have raised your hand for the read. Is there any other question you have regarding the passage that we read?
No, I have to read that.
So students, now I haven't put any other text on the screen right now. We will be putting our concentration completely in the textbook. Tushar will start reading from page number 16. Give me a thumbs up if you can understand this particular instruction. Yeah, perfect. Tushar, please go ahead, page number 16.
In recognition of his feat, he was awarded the Distinguished Flying Cross, DFC, on the spot by the Supreme Allied Commander of Southeast Asia, the first Indian pilot to have received it. Singh was selected for the Empire Pilot Training Course at Royal Air Force, RAF.
Cranwell
in 1938, when he was 19 years old, he retired from service in 1969.
Yeah, please continue the next paragraph as well.
Singh was born on April 15, 1919 in Lalpur, now Faisalabad, Pakistan, and completed his education at
Montgomery.
His first assignment on being commissioned was to fly Western Wapiti biplanes in the northwestern frontier province. As a member of the number one RIAF squadron.
That's it. Okay, students, 5 seconds to find out words or something that that was new to you, or something that describes Arjun Singh's character.
Miss, I can't see you.
Biplanes.
Okay, there was confusion. Somebody said a word. Can you please repeat?
Beach planes.
biplanes. Is that the word that you were searching for? Is that the word you said?
Yes, yes.
Yeah, so biplanes is simple. It is an old type of aircraft. It's a kind of an aircraft that has two wings. Okay, let me see if I can find the picture. Just a minute. Just a moment. Let me see if I can stop sharing and find the picture. Give me a moment, okay? Others, if there is any other word, biplanes is one thing. What else was different for you? Okay, I'm sharing my screen again. Please let me know if it's visible. Is my screen visible? Yeah. So Ankit, your question, what is a biplane? This is a biplane. It's an old kind of an aircraft that were used in the by the forces. So Arjun Singh has actually flown this kind of aircraft as well. Clear now?
Miss, can you zoom?
Just a moment. Let me just select one image. Is it visible?
Yes, yes.
Yeah. So anybody else even had a question as to what is a biplane? This is what a biplane looks like.
Miss, I have one question.
Yes, please go ahead. Yes, ask Ankit.
Miss, we can find biplanes nowadays in India.
There might be a biplane in the display, but they don't use it anymore. When you go, is there any museums? If you go to the museums, they have the biplanes to show the people as to what they look like, but they don't fly it anymore. It's according to the safety measures, it does not meet all the requirements. Any other word? Anybody else? Did have any question with the words? Otherwise, we can move ahead. Ankit, for the read, you're putting your hand up.
Yes.
Okay. Anybody else for a read? Just a moment. Okay, Ankit. Let me just see if anybody else is there. Anybody else interested? Which screen, Chan? Okay. Chan, are you unable to see the PPT or the screen? Poem page. Oh, okay. Poem page. It's not a poem, it's a lesson. Just a moment. I'll have to see how do I do it. Okay. Till that time, Chan, just a moment. Let me see how I can put the rest of the chapter on the screen. Ankit, you can please start reading from after.
After a brief stint with the newly formed number 2 RIAF squadron where the marshal flew is against the triple post
tribal force.
He later moved back to number 1 squadron as a flying officer to fly the Hawker units.
Hurricanes.
He was promoted to the rank of squadron leader in 1944.
Next.
For his role in successfully leading the squadron in combat, he was awarded the Distinguished Flying Cross DFC in 1944. On August 15, 1947, he achieved the unique honor of leading a fly past over 100 IAF aircraft over the Red Fort in India?
In Delhi, sorry. Just a moment. Okay. Akhilesh, is it a question that you wish to ask or is it a doubt? Or is it a read? Akhilesh? Reading. Yeah, just a moment, Akhilesh, will go ahead. I should have asked this question before. It is my mistake. Can you all just confirm how many of you all have the textbook? I'm really sorry. I should have asked this before. Students have textbook 4, 5. Students who do not have the textbook, can you please give me a thumbs down? Rahul doesn't have the textbook. Shubham, do you have the? I'm hoping you have done the thumbs up. That means you have the textbook.
Okay. Yes.
Okay, Chand, I'm seeing in my textbook. Perfect. Okay, thank you. Fatima and Farah. You raised your hand, Fatima. Is there a question you need to ask? Okay, no problem. Okay, so there were practically no words that gave us any character stakes about Arjun Singh in these two paragraphs that Ankit just read. Was there any word that you found new or difficult in that particular paragraph? Quickly put it in the chat box, or maybe, you know, go raise your hand, go off mute and ask.
A brief stint, number 2.
A brief stint means a small period of work. For a little time, he was working at the place. Small period of work. Okay, so... would anybody else like to go for a read? Chand, if I'm not wrong. Akhilesh, yes, please go ahead after his promotion.
After his promotion to the rank of wing commander, he attended the Royal Staff College at the UK. Immediately after Indian independence, the commanded Amla in the rank of group captain. In 1949, he was promoted to the rank of air commander and took over as air officer commanding of an operational command, which later came to be known as Western Air Command.
Yeah, please continue and complete both the paragraphs.
Singh had the distinction of having the longest tenure as AOC of an operational base, initially from 1949 to 1952, and then again from 1957 to 1961. After his promotion to the rank of Air
Vice Marshal,
he was appointed as OAOC in C of an operational command.
Okay, complete the last paragraph as well.
Towards the end of 1962 war, he was appointed as the deputy chief of the air staff, and he became the vice chief of the air staff in 1963. He was the overall commander of the joint air training exercise. Shiksha had between IAF and RAF Royal Air Force and RAAF Royal Australian Air Force.
Okay, perfect. Thank you. Now, any words that you found different, new? There are a couple of words that I have marked which are new for me. Yes, Rahul?
Miss, I can't see screen. I mean only first screen, that's quadrant.
Do you have the textbook, Rahul? Because the next to the things I have not put in the textbook. We are going through the textbook and we are reading from the textbooks. Okay, Akhilesh. Tenure, I'll give you the meaning of tenure. Okay. Tenure means period. Timeline. Timeline. Kitne time tak tenure. So if I say my tenure in my class has my tenure in school was 10 years, that means I studied in the school for 10 years. That's my timeline. Tenure means timeline. Yes, Ankit.
Miss AOC/IN/C.
Yeah, that's a air official commanding in chief. That's the title. Like how you call it's principal, ma'am. So principal is the title. Principal so and so. So principal is the title. So that AOC/IN/C is the title. The full form, if you have the textbook, is given at the left hand side. Air official commanding in chief. Distinction means in top, at the top. Distinction means at the top or the best.
Miss, can you repeat again what is the full form?
Air officer commanding in chief. Yeah, Tushar, it's a correct example. PM has 5-year tenure. Flying post is a place. When you're flying, you can find those as an indication as this is the base or that is a post. It's a marking. Okay, so we are almost on the end of the lecture. Like 1 more minute to go. So any other word that is new for you all? Anything else that you could not understand while Akhilesh was reading, or that was new to you? Yeah. So I'm hoping that most of the things. So what we're going to do right now is we'll be continuing the read tomorrow because we could not complete it today. It's already 8:45. Okay. So what we're going to do is today you'll go back to the chapter again, and your homework, okay, I'm giving you what you're supposed to do after we are done with the lesson. On page number 17, go through the topic, go through the page, okay, by yourself individually. And what we did today in the classroom right now was to mark what were the words that gave explanation of Arjun Singh's personality and any other word that you find difficult, and underline those words and keep. If there's any word that you find difficult while you're reading the passage today after the class, please underline them. Tomorrow, we'll read the passage again together as we did right now. Okay, and we'll sort out the meanings. Is it clear? Would anybody like to repeat what are we going to do after we are done with the lesson today, after we finish up today's class? Chat box will also do. Anybody would like
to? Miss, I have one doubt.
Yes, Ankit, ask.
Miss, like in this Air Force, Arjun Singh, he has. Oh.
Ankit, I cannot hear you properly. Hello.
Miss, miss, इधर पे gold gold जैसा कुछ दिखाई दे रहा है, वो क्या है?
कहाँ पे? उनके uniform पे.
Yes.
Those are his medals.
No, after that.
This? It's his uniform. That's the pattern of his uniform.
Okay, Miss.
Yeah.
Okay. So, would anyone of you... Okay, I'm repeating the instructions again. Yes, Rahul. Question?
Miss, what did medal represent?
Medal represents the number of... standards that he's crossed. So like if I'm a junior, so I won't have any medal. if I've done something for my country, if I've done something really valerious, valerious means something brave, or I've contributed to my country in a positive sense, then I get a medal, so I may, you know, go ahead. So from first when you enter into, I'll say about the army. So first when you're entering into army, you're a lieutenant or maybe a soldier, then you get a promotion, then you become a lieutenant, then a major. So according to your ranks, you get the medals. So the medal represents your ranking in the Air Force or in the particular armed force. Thank you. Perfect. So lastly, before I close out the space, I'm repeating the instructions again for what you'll be doing after the lesson. Please give me a thumbs up when you understand. You will be reading page number 17 and you will be marking the words which describe Arjun Singh's character or the word which is new for you to understand. That is all you will doing today after you go out of this lecture, and we'll be discussing the whole and reading the passage again tomorrow. Yes? One. Quickly, thumbs up. Yes, Ankit, just a moment, Ankit. Yeah. Yeah. So last question by Ankit, please ask, then we'll close up for the day.
Miss, in Indian Army, how many, after the person retire, how many age of that?
If I'm not wrong, the official age is... Okay, I'll get back to you with the correct answer. I really don't want to give you any assumption answers for this. I'll give the answer to you for this tomorrow. Okay, Ankit?
Okay.
Thank you. Okay, so we're closing up the space right now. Siddharth, sir, anything you would like to say? I'm stopping the ship.
Yes, Lekha ma'am. Thank you. Can you please share that picture again? Okay, so some students asked what is this part of the rope-like thing that he is wearing. It is actually a rope. It is not cloth. It is actually a rope. And there is a history when people in the olden times, when there were not many equipments, even today, when there are so many equipments, we have so many technologies in use.